I am telling you that it's not a fault. If you doubt, read this book and boost your faith in Christ. And know that, like the pastor is saying, the man of God is saying, we all have our different crises. We all have our challenges and our world different. I can never be you. So therefore, don't envy anybody. Be in your lane. When you see somebody growing, be happy. Unforgiveness spirit is a deadly, poisonous thing that will make us one day lose the kingdom of God. The little thing that you underestimate. Once upon a time in my life, it wasn't easy for me. Things that I deserved, they deny. I live with people and serve them. They maltreat me. They put me all, they did all kind of things. So therefore, even though when I confessed Christ, there was part of me that still have that hatred for the people that did me wrong. I am telling you, you don't know where you are today in your life. Maybe you are holding on to some old things that is not making the breakthrough comes in. Maybe you need to forgive them. Even when there are some forgiveness, you have to forgive. Even all, even when you did not do the thing, even when you are even right, sometimes you just have to forgive, not for them, but for yourself, so that your blessings will come, so that those people, you will not be a slave. So, because whatever it is that you don't forgive in your life, you become a slave to that situation, that they take in charge of your life and destroy you. Bitterness. Gives cancer, kidneys, stuff. Just bitterness. Our kids, our husbands, our brothers, our family, our friends. What are we holding on against them that is not making our prayer get to the Most High God? Whatever it is that you have in your heart, please read this book, and then you will have a reason and a cause and a purpose. First of all, to ask yourself, Jesus has the life manual of individual year. So therefore, when things are complicated, go to him. Go to the word of God. Read it yourself. Meditate on it. And ask him, Father, you created me. You have every part of my body belongs to you. If it is healing you want, you have the power. Believe it. Amen. And declare. Guess what? If you don't have nothing, you cannot stand on nothing to declare. You have to have the word. He himself has given us our will, and the man of God is saying, to choose life or death. Today, let's search within our hearts if today should be the last day of our lives. Where are we going? Is it the negativity, the greed? What will deny you of not entering into the kingdom of God? Search within your heart. If you are lacking something, I believe in sowing seed. When I want something great to happen in my life, put an envelope, money in an envelope, pray on it, and sow a seed on a good soil. Not just any churches. If you are in this church and you go to some, that means you don't even know who you are. You sow it, whereby they will lay hands and they will pray. Dare yourself. Up to today, when I say it, people think it's a lie. Sometimes I'm into businesses and buying and selling, blessing and offer. You would think that somebody somewhere is working. I should be here, do my share, maybe like I do all, I bless more, I give more, but I seek God for direction, not just for anybody, but the right people who are in need. Not the lazy ones that are calling and being on internet and to know. Do something extraordinary this December. Let God touch your heart to sow in your father's, your papa's life. Whatever situation, if you like, sometimes trust God. Dare him, don't write anything at all. He knows us. When the curtains are drawn, we are naked before him. Say, God, I am trusting you. This lady says, if I sow seed, you do miracle. What you did for her, you will do it for me. Just trust God and put something and say, Lord, if you like, don't even write your name. He's the can-do God.
Amen.
The possibility God.
Amen.
He make way when there is no way. The book of Psalm 91 from 7 to 16. Test him. Try him. Do something. Let it cost you. You can even say you are changing the decoration here. Everything. Like, you have to have something in your hand to break through. If it's a good marriage you are looking for, you have to pray and ask God to give you a man that you, in that man, you see the manifestation of God's glory. Because through it all, if the fear of God is there, guess what? No matter what, if it's education, if it's scholarship, whatever it is, I urge you, support a good cause. Support this church. If you forget about everything I'm saying, because I don't want to go into deep, because I want you to read this book. Esther, an orphan, stood in the gap for a whole nation to be saved.
Amen.
Even your own local church. Look at the chairs. They are empty. Evangelism, soul winning. Let's